Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My name is Isaac Livingston. I am a pastor of the Church of God denomination. Now I am retired. I have some clips on YouTube under True Gospel of Christ. And I also have a website that is www.truegospel.com. And today's topic is declaration of faith. It's just a preview, just a beginning. And we all have declaration of faith in our denominations and our churches. What is the declaration? It is a list of our primary doctrines. It is created by our theologians and our leaders. They use Bible verses here and there to give an appearance that it is from the Word of God. But really it is not. Yet we respect our declarations as God's Word. I thought that it may be profitable to some of us if I write the declarations of faith directly from the Bible, so that we may use them for ourselves. Today, I will give the preview of the declaration and I will explain them in detail with scripture references within a few days. The first point in the declaration is to tell about the Bible. The Bible is inerrant, infallible. Inerrant is free from error. Infallible is incapable of making an error. The Bible, which is the Word of God, not only does not have an error, but it cannot lead anyone to make an error. I have added a caution about the modern English translations and their motives. Point number two, it is about Trinity. Trinity says that God is three, but He is one. God is one Spirit, and He is the only Spirit who is omnipotent. And He has three persons in Him, that is, He has three souls in His Spirit. If we look at God as a Spirit, then He is one. But if we look at God as a person, He is three. So, God is three in one. The next point, point number three, God has created us in His own image. That is, He has created us exactly as He is. The Bible also says we are created in the likeness of Him. That is, we have His resemblance. So, it is two different things. What do we have that is exactly like Him? And what do we have that has His resemblance? We will discuss that. Point number four. Adam and Eve died on the same day when they ate fruit from the tree of knowledge. But Adam lived for 930 years and Eve also lived with him. So how could they die on the same day when they ate the fruit? And at the same time, lived for 930 years. This is how. They had a body, soul, and spirit. Their spirit died on the same day, and the soul continued to live with their bodies for 930 years. It was their spiritual death. Point number five is very important. The Holy Ghost is a spirit. The Holy Spirit also is a spirit. We all say the Holy Ghost is the Holy Spirit, and they both are the same spirit with different names. But it is not so. The Bible says that the Holy Ghost is God, and the Holy Spirit is a gift given by God to us. Look at this example. The blasphemy against the Holy Ghost will not be forgiven. And so, if we blaspheme against the Holy Ghost, we will be in hell forever. And one more thing, if the Holy Ghost lives in us, that is, abides in us, we will become the temple of God. As His temple, if we defile ourselves with sin, or defile our bodies with sin, God will destroy us and we will be damned. So, we must be very careful with the Holy Ghost as 10,000 volts of electricity. If we are not careful, we will be killed eternally. But God gives the Holy Spirit to us as a gift. The Spirit will help us. We can grieve, or we can even quench the Spirit, which is equivalent to killing the Spirit. One Spirit can destroy us eternally, but we can destroy the other Spirit. How can both Spirit be the same? The Holy Ghost is God, and the Holy Spirit is a gift from God. Next, number six. It is about Sabbath day. A few Christian leaders say that Sabbath day is Sunday. It is not true. Common Sabbath day is Saturday, the seventh day of the week. But there are special Sabbath days in the Bible, but that is not in question here. Again, Christians think that Sabbath day is a worship day. No, we can worship God any day, at any time, 24/7. There's no restriction for worship. Sabbath day is a mandatory rest day. God imposed Sabbath only on the Jews and their household, including their servants. Among them, if anybody did not keep the Sabbath day, they must be stoned to death. This is how they keep the Sabbath day holy. Seventh-day Adventists say that we must keep the Sabbath day holy. They don't even keep the Sabbath, which is the complete rest. How could they keep it holy? They do not keep the Sabbath day rest. One more thing, they will not tell you, or nobody tell anybody, is Sabbath day commandments is revoked by Jesus Christ. Instead, He gives eternal rest to those who labor and are heavy laden. It is in Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 to 30, and it is explained in details in chapter 4 of the book of Hebrews. Let me read chapter 11 from Matthew, verse 28. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Verse 29, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. So Jesus Christ says, learn from him how to receive the yoke, and we can receive the rest from him. The Sabbath day is Saturday, and it is revoked by Jesus Christ. And we can receive His rest from Him. That is the Sabbath for the New Testament believers. This is just a preview. And in the future sessions, and we will study the declaration about the virgin birth of Jesus, water baptism for forgiveness of sins, what is the true evidence of the Holy Ghost baptism, born of the Spirit and eternal life, when will the second coming of Jesus Christ be? Bible says clearly when He will be coming, and we'll study it. Jesus comes for four times, and we'll study all those in details with Scripture. And what is grace, and who receives the grace of God? Christianity as our life, as well as a religion, and a few other things. And explain them very details with Scripture. Without Scripture, I won't present anything, and I'm looking forward to the explanations, and I'll come quickly. And one other thing is, now I'm just beginning on the video. It's already completed in the text form, the truegospel.com. If you want to check in, check it out. And from there, the first item is the declaration. You can click and find out. Thank you very much for listening. I'll post the next video soon, The declaration of faith will be based on only the scriptures, like I said, and I wish you all the best. God bless you. May His presence be with you all the time. Amen.